Hello everyone. In today's computer networks lab class, we will discuss program 3. Program 3 is to simulate an Ethernet LAN using N nodes and set multiple traffic nodes and plot congestion window for different source or destination. So we have to simulate an Ethernet, okay? And you can use N number of nodes, whatever you are comfortable with. But you have to actually set up the traffic on different nodes. That means you should have more than one source node here, okay? Two different traffic you should set up, and then you have to collect the congestion window information, and then you have to plot the congestion window for different source or destination. So first we will see the key points, like what is Ethernet and then what is congestion and all those things, and before actually getting into the program logic. What is Ethernet, first of all? So Ethernet is a technology, okay? It is a technology that connects wired local area networks. That means it is a wired LAN. Ethernet is a wired LAN and enables the device to communicate with each other through a protocol, which is the common network language. So through this we can actually communicate with the wired LAN. It will set up a wired LAN. And to know more about Ethernet LAN, so Ethernet is a wired LAN, yes, we know that, and it is a protocol present in data link layer, okay? It's a protocol which is actually present in data link layer. So this Ethernet LAN will be in the data link layer. You know the OSI layers, right? What are the layers we have? In that, it comes under data link layer. And then again, this data link layer actually consists of two sub layers, okay? First one is MAC, Media Access Control. And second one is LLC, that is logical link control. So data link has LLC sublayer as well as MAC sublayer. So why do you want these two? Because you have to set up Ethernet LAN, right? Then whenever you are setting up the Ethernet LAN, you have to set up these two as well. That's why I'm giving this theory funda before even starting the project. You remember this. So data link layer has two sub layers, that is a LLC sub layer as well as MAC, because whenever you are setting up the LAN, we will use it again there. So next keyword that we used in our program definition is congestion. So what is actually congestion? Network congestion is the reduced quality of service. That means the network is congested, right? The quality of service has been reduced, and that occurs when a network node or link is carrying more data than it can handle. It's like your traffic jam, okay? Because of that, just because the road, more vehicles are there on the road than it can handle, we are facing the congestion there, right? The same way here, we have the network or node or link, okay? It's carrying more data than it can handle. So then because of that, the quality of service has been reduced. This situation is called as network congestion. So next, what is congestion window? Because in our program, we have to, we have to plot the congestion window. We know what is congestion. Now we should know what is congestion window. Rest all we discussed, right? Ethernet LAN we know, N nodes we know how to set up, and then we know multiple traffic should be there. After that we discussed about congestion as well. Now the thing is, what is congestion window then? So yeah, these things we discussed already. Now we'll get into congestion window. We have one more parameter, that is receiver window. So CWND stands for congestion window, and then RWND stands for receiver window. We'll just see what are they. Though we don't need this receiver window in my program, but this is indirectly supporting it. So congestion window, CWND, is a TCP state variable. It is actually a variable used in TCP connection that limits the amount of data the TCP can send into the network before receiving an acknowledgement. So you are sending the data into the network and you also receive the acknowledgement, right? For example, if you send one packet, instead of waiting for that acknowledgement for that particular packet, you can simultaneously keep sending few more packets because it will be going in line and then you will start receiving the acknowledgement. I hope you have seen that in theory classes whenever we were discussing about TCP. See, for example, this is my source node. Okay, just check that one. This is my source node. This is my destination. I've already sent one packet. Okay, I've already sent one. If my congestion window is equal to 4, that means I've already sent one packet from source to destination. I've sent one more, 2, 3, 4, but I have not received any acknowledgement till now. But I will not send fifth packet because my congestion window is 4. That means I can only send 4 packets without receiving acknowledgement for this one. Okay, so first packet I have sent, second packet, third packet, fourth packet. That means I have sent four packets and I'll wait till I receive the acknowledgement of first packet. If I receive this, only then I'm going to send the next packet. What does it mean? In the network, I can only have 4 packets without receiving the acknowledgement. So that is the congestion window. I hope the congestion window concept is clear. So this receiver window is actually a variable that advertises the amount of data that the destination side can receive. So this is actually for receiver side, how much it can receive. So it's like an advertisement. Yes, I can receive 10 means you can of course set your congestion window to 10, right? Because your receiver has that capacity. So together these two variables are actually used to regulate the data flow in TCP connection. And these two are used to minimize the congestion and improve the network performance. So now we will get into the actual concept, how it works. Okay, it actually works in couple of phases. First one is slow start congestion control. Okay, in slow start congestion control, what TCP does, it increases the congestion window size rapidly because it has to reach the maximum transfer rate, right? It cannot have minimum because it needs to send the packets as soon as possible. So TCP increases the window size rapidly to reach maximum transfer rate as fast as possible, right? You can observe that here. See, this is the slow start phase. This is the congestion window. Initially you have some value and it keeps increasing. So this is time actually. Okay, so slow start phase, you are increasing it rapidly, exponentially you are increasing it just to reach the maximum threshold side and send all the packets as soon as possible. Okay, and this self-imposed window size increase as TCP confirms the network ability to transmit the data without errors. Okay, so however, what is the maximum limit? Of course, we know that, right? This can only go up to a maximum advertised window, receiving window, because it can only receive 10 means there is no point in increasing your congestion window to more than 10. So the maximum it can reach, RWND. Okay, this scenario, the sender actually uses two variables. What is that? So congestion window with an initial value of 1 maximum segment size. So that means here initially I'll just use 1 maximum segment sizes. That means one segment I am sending initially. So that is my MSS. Okay, and then the slow start threshold value, slow start threshold, SS thresh. So what is that? Here is the slow start threshold value. That means up to that I go in the slow start value, slow start phase. After that I'll move to linear fashion because here I am almost reaching the congestion. So here the congestion occurs, right? So this is the threshold value. Till here I go in slow start, and after reaching the threshold I'll be in a linear fashion. Here it is exponential, and after threshold I'll go in a linear fashion. I'll increase my congestion window in linear fashion. Okay, and yeah, the congestion window increases exponentially during congestion control. Yes, we have seen that. And linearly during the congestion avoidance phase. We saw that, right? This is congestion control. So this is actually called as congestion control. Okay, this phase. And this one is actually congestion avoidance. So slow start occurs when congestion window is less than threshold. Yes, we know that. And congestion avoidance occurs when congestion window is greater than or equal to threshold. And then at the end, what happens? So it will be in congestion avoidance phase, but whenever a packet has been lost, that means congestion has occurred, right? Or we have received three duplicate acknowledgement. If you have studied TCP, you know that if you are receiving three duplicate acknowledgement, means you have lost the packet, right? That means congestion has occurred. Then what we do, then the congestion has dropped to zero, right? That means, so if at all, see, I am in congestion avoidance. Any moment if I lose one packet or I receive three duplicate acknowledgement, I drop it back. Okay, I drop it to zero. Or then what I do, I'll set a new threshold value. I'll set a new threshold value and then it will continue. It will drop. See, it will drop all of a sudden. Okay. So this is how, actually see, what and all I told till now, right? You are not going to code for that because that is the behavior of TCP. Till now, I was only explaining how TCP behaves. Be careful with that. Okay, you are not going to code all this because you have already TCP available in network simulator. Now what you have to do, you have to only create the network, generate the traffic, and you have to get this congestion window value, how and all it is actually increasing it. Then you have to plot a graph like this to observe the behavior of TCP. I hope the aim of the program is clear. See, I've taken one output sample. This is the output of program 3. You can observe the pattern. The pattern is same like this. It goes, it reaches the peak and then it drops down, right? See, it goes. I've taken two different sources. Okay, this is again time here. This is the congestion window. How many packets I'm starting? See here, I'm starting with one actually basically. So that's why it is starting here. So one packet as the congestion window. So y-axis congestion, x-axis time. Okay, so it start here, it goes to the peak, then it drops, right? And then it will start, goes to the peak. See, exponential, linear, and then it will drop. Exponential, linear, it drops. So red stands for one source and green is actually for the other source. Clear? Now the aim of the project is clear. Now let us get into the code. So here is the code. Few quite obvious things I will skip them because the program is lengthy. So I'll let you know which program you can refer. So create simulator, set NS new simulator. We are creating the new simulator here. So this also I have explained it in program 1. You can refer to that. And I'll be using two different colors for the traffic. So one is blue and one is red. Same thing I've already explained in program 1. And then I'm creating two important NAM file as well as trace file here. Again, I've already explained, so I'll skip this part as well. As usual, I'm creating a NAM file and trace file. And here, these two are extra lines. So I need to create two files here with more. So 0 and 1, because each file I'm using, they're just the flat files. Okay. These are not the trace file, just flat file, just to have this information of congestion window. Each time, what is the congestion window? Okay, value. So to save that, I'm creating these two files. As usual, next I have finish procedure. I'll get back to it when I call it. After finish procedure, I have a plot window procedure here. Again, I'll get back to it when I call that procedure. Okay. Yeah. So after that, so here my execution flow continues. So create 6 nodes. They have asked me to create n number of nodes, right? So I'm creating 6 nodes, something like that. Just assume this topology. So I'm using this for loop to create nodes, which you are already aware how to use the for loop to create 6 nodes. I've already explained it in program 1 and 2 on how you can create the nodes. Okay, so next, so orientation again. Orientation comes next. Here I'm creating duplex links between the nodes. So here I'm creating the from 0 to 2, I'm creating one duplex link. I've already explained how to create in program 1, and 1 to 2, I'm creating a duplex link, and 2 to 3, one more duplex links. So these three links I have created here. Note 3, 4 and 5 are considered in LAN. So only 3, 4 and 5. These nodes I am actually connecting in the LAN. So this is a new syntax here. We never created any LAN till now, right, in our programs. So this is the syntax, set LAN, okay, NS new LAN. So all the nodes that you want to put it in the LAN, connect in the LAN, you have to mention it here, 3, 4 as well as 5. So bandwidth of it, the capacity, okay, and next comes the simulation time. Okay, simulation time 40 milliseconds. And then LL, what is this? Logical link. That's why I told you, right? We in data link layer, I have two parameters again, two sub layers. One is logical link as well as the MAC, right? In logical link, I'll be using Q drop tile, whereas in MAC, I am using the 802.3 standard. So you, instead of dot, you have to put underscore like this. So these are these two. That's why I've explained that in the beginning itself. So and the data link layer has two sub layers. One is logical link as well as the MAC. So logical link is LL, and I'm using drop tile Q type. In under MAC, I'm using 802.3 standard to set up the LAN. With this, I have tied these three into the LAN. These three are separate nodes, whereas I have connected this to the node 3. Clear? And I have done some orientation here. So to my 2 comes right side down to 0 and my right side up to 1. Okay, right up, and then 2, 3 comes right side to 2. So this orientation part also I have already explained in program 1. So you can just refer to that for details. Okay, then now, yeah, so set up queue between 2 and 3 and monitor the queues. I have set up 2 and 3. Between 2 and 3, I have set up the queues of size 20. And then here, again, I have queue pause 0.5. Okay, so next, so I have set up the queue. Next, I am actually introducing some error. So what is the need of this error? Because anyway, I need to create some congestion, right? That means few packets should be lost, or I should receive duplicate acknowledgement. So when does this happen? Only when you have some net packets getting dropped, right? Or some error should occur. So that's why I'm actually setting up the error model between 2 and 3. So the same here, okay? So between 2 and 3, I'm setting up some error. Intentionally, I'm setting up error model. So this is the actually syntax for that. Remember syntax of these four lines. So here basically I'm setting up the error model just to drop some packets so that some error occurs and I can easily observe the congestion window behavior. Okay, so next, see, I need to now set up the TCP, right? Till now I only set up the LAN. I've never actually set up the TCP connection. See, here I am setting up the TCP connection between 0 and 4. Okay, 0 and 4. Just check that one. Between 0 and 4. Like for 0 as well as 4, I am setting up the TCP connection. Okay, so we know that, right? Syntax of all, we have already explained. We create the agent and then all other fields like packet ID window and then FID. All these things, and then we attach that particular agent to the node to which I want to make it as a TCP protocol. So that I have done, and then I have set it as a sync 0. That is done, right? And node 4 also, I am creating one more sync 0 and then I am connecting TCP 0. Okay, so that is done. I have connected these two, TCP 0 and sync 0. So basically from here to here, I am only creating the TCP. I am making these two nodes to follow TCP. And then for traffic, I am actually, and why are we using TCP? As we are actually talking about the congestion, right? And what is the specialty of TCP? We all know that, right? TCP actually has congestion control, flow control. So this would be the best protocol to use here. So this would be the best transport layer protocol to use. Okay, I have created TCP. This also I have already explained in other programs, right? 1 and 2. And then yeah, I am using the FTP application over the TCP. For traffic, I am using the file transfer protocol here. In others, I have used CBR, right? Constant bit rate. Same way here, I am using FTP. How do I do that? Again, I create the agent and then I attach agent to that particular TCP, right? So FTP0 I have created, and then I have actually set it up to TCP0. So whatever node has a TCP0, then it will actually have the FTP traffic, file transfer protocol. I am applying it there. So that will be the application layer protocol. And again, so next I am actually setting up another TCP connection between 5 and 1. So first what I did, initially I did it from 0 to 4, right? This being source and this being destination. Now I'll make 5 as the source and 1 as the destination, and I create one more TCP. Okay, I created between 0 and 4, 1, and then the other one is 5 and 1. Why am I doing this? Because in my program, it is demanding me to have multiple traffic, source and destination. So same thing, whatever we did before, right? So whatever we did here for 0 and 4, the same thing we are doing it for 5 and 1. So we have created TCP and then attached to agent, and then I am applying file transfer protocol application. Okay, this is the application layer protocol over TCP, because I need some traffic, right? So I have attached it to the source node. So done. So here starts the actual thing. So now what did I do? I just created the network, right? I created the traffic, I created the topology, everything done. So now, how do I actually, when do I start the traffic? How do I collect the congestion window? Now the main logic starts in the scheduling. See, at time 0.1, I am starting the FTP0. So first traffic actually starts at 0, time 0.1. At the same time, I'll start a plot window. I'll call plot window file. So that means I need TCP0. DCP0 is nothing but my 0th node, right? TCP0, and I'm using WinFile0. Initially, we created two files. Do you remember? I told you this is specially only for this program. So Win0 and Win1. So I am giving that file as the input to plot window TCP0 and then WinFile0. That means anyway traffic has started, right? So I'll use this particular node to get the data of congestion, what is happening and all that, and I'll store that in WinFile0. Let me see what is this plot window is doing. Okay, see here I have this plot window procedure written on top. Yeah. So what my plot window is doing, see, it actually takes again, yeah, TCP source file. TCP source is my 0th node and then file, WinFile0, right? And I have a global NS, and then I'm setting a variable time as 0.1. I'll use this further, I'll explain it. And then here set now NS now. That means now is nothing but the current time instance. What exactly is the time now, right? So that instance of time is actually this now refers to. Okay, so now this CWND, this is the congestion window, set congestion window. So for TCP source, what is my TCP source here? 0th node. Set CWND underscore. What is this CWND underscore? See, this CWND underscore, so this congestion window we know, right? So it's actually a state variable that limits the amount of data the TCP can send into the network before receiving an acknowledgement, right? So we are actually setting that variable, and then what happens, we'll actually put file now and then congestion window. So what are we doing here? This puts is nothing but it will record the current timestamp as well as the congestion window value to this file. What is this file? I have actually given win0, right? While calling itself, do you remember where did I call? So plot window I called for TCP0, that means 0th node, and then WinFile0. right? I'll just show you the WIN file. How does it? I'll just show you the WIN file. How does it look like? See here, I've just copied the WIN files that got generated. So I'll just open it. They are just plain files, okay? I'll just open it in Notepad. See here. See, why is it starting a time? So this first, there it has only two columns. First column is time, okay? Why only two columns? See here. So in plot window, what am I recording? The current time instance, right? And then the congestion window value. So who is actually giving the congestion window? Of course, your TCP protocol itself is actually calculating all that. That's why I told you are not doing anything to this. Your TCP is already doing. You are only recording the values and plotting the graph. That's it, okay? So your the current timestamp of your simulation timestamp, current instance time, and then the congestion window. That's what your puts is nothing but you're recording that into the file. What is this file? Win0. Clear? So this file, anyways, it will this file actually gets generated in the home directory only, wherever you have the code. I just copied it here. So win0 is here. I have opened it in Notepad. See. So why is it actually starting at 0.10? Any idea? Because see here. So I have called this particular program at 0.1 time only. So that's why it starts recording it from 0.1, and this is my congestion window. That means initially I transfer only one. And then yeah, I add next time also one, and then it becomes two. Okay, so it keeps going up to the peak value of 85. Do you remember I had showed one curve here that this has the output. See here, it had reached up to this point, this curve, right? It went from 0 to, it went till here. So it reached up to 84. Can you see that? So congestion window and time. So it went up to here. You can observe it later. I'm just telling that output now itself. Okay. So that means it went from there to here. Right? So did you check that congestion window value? See here. So it went up to 85 at time 4.5. See, at time 4.5, it went up to 85, the first peak. So red starts for WIN0, WIN file 0. Can you see here? So WIN file 0 is the red color one. So it went up to 85 and then it is coming down. So exactly, you are actually copying these values here so that you can plot the graph. So this is what your WIN file 0 is. That means for every timestamp, it's actually calculating, it's actually recording it. So your plot window file is function or procedure is actually recording, see, up to 25.10. why 25.10? let us see in the code why it is stopping exactly at this point. See here, exactly at 25.10, you are actually stopping that particular traffic. Okay, so 25.0, you are stopping it. So, of course, it will stop creating everything. 25.2, you are just finishing only. Right? So, that's why it is actually recording up to that particular point. Okay, so what else it was doing? The plot window procedure. Yes, it actually... it records everything in the WIN0 file. That's nothing but this file, right? So I'm just giving the variable name. So WIN0 was the file that I have put it here. And next, yes. And then what and all we have. And one more thing. Did you observe? If you just call it once, it will only record one value, right? But we have an infinite loop here. So it will keep on calling the same plot window. See? Inside plot window, I'm calling this plot window again and again, again and again. Why? Because see, I'm actually EXPR, see this time, what is this time? Time I have set it as 0.1. That means every like instance plus 0.1, every step I am recording it. So I keep on calling this one every, like I'll wait for 0.1 time and then I'm calling it again. That's why you here you can see right in the file, for every 0.1 step you have a record here. That is because you're calling this function within this function itself again and again. Clear? So after once it finishes it, what happens? Yes, 0.1 I'm calling it, so it keeps on recording it in an infinite loop. And 0.5 time, what happens? I'm starting the FTP1. So that means second source, right? At 5, node 5. And then what happens at 5 again? I start recording it in win file 1. Okay, so again the same thing repeats but in a different file. Clear? At 25, what happens? I'm stopping my first FTP 0, that means first traffic. At 25.1, I'm stopping the second traffic, and at 25.2, I'm calling the finish procedure. So till now, I have my data only in the win files. Right, so within this finish procedure only I'm actually plotting the graph. Let us see what is happening. So all these initial things are same as usual. I'm not going to explain it, you can refer to program one. So proc finish, global ns, create, you're flushing the trace now, and then closing entries, closing nam file, and then you execute the program dot nam file because you want to see the animated output, network animation. And here comes the X graph. I'm using X graph, okay, to plot the graph. It is straightforward. You just use this function, execute X graph, and you are giving input as win file 0 and win file 1. What win file 0 has for first node, right, first source, what is the congestion window for each time, right? It has recorded that. And win file 2, win file 1, it has for the other node, that is source 5, right? So I'm just giving these two to plot the graph. X graph will plot the graph taking these two data, and then I exit it, right? And then these are all the things that I have, and to run this whole simulation I have this command ns run. Okay, I hope you understood the code. Now let us execute the program and see. Have logged into Ubuntu. Let me open the terminal. So I'm using vi editor, vi file name dot tcl, file name dot tcl, type in the code here. Okay, I've just pasted it. So escape colon WQ, you will get back to the terminal. Then ns program 3.tcl, file name dot tcl. So just hit enter. The program will get executed. Yes, you can see the animation window, network animation window, as well as the graph. First let us see how it runs. Okay, let me just run the simulation and observe it, how exactly the packets are moving. We might have to increase the simulation speed. Just increase the simulation speed so that you can see the traffic in two different colors, because we have selected the red as well as blue, right? And also, do you see we are generating traffic from node 0 as well as from node 5. Right? And we have so many packet losses and we have errors. Let us wait till the simulation ends. So yeah, it's almost, I've just increased the speed. You can observe it, right? I'm just increasing the speed of it. So that, let me just finish this off. Our main thing is to analyze the graph now, right? So I'll just want to finish this off. I'll just increase the speed a little more. So this is anyway the just the animation window. Yeah, it got completed. So let me open the graph. So I've already explained how to analyze the graph, right? So for win file 0 and win file 1, I have just open it, open the both the files, okay, and analyze the values whether you are getting the same values that you have. So both win files will be there in your home directory wherever your code is saved. So just go to home and then open win file 0 and win file 1. Wherever you have your trace file, right, the same place you will get them. So you can just analyze the way I have already explained in this video. So yeah, that's it all about program 3. So thank you.